Learning medicine is hard work. Osmosis makes it easy. It takes your lectures and notes to create a personalized study plan with exclusive videos, practice questions, and flashcards, and so much more. Try it free today.
Bullous pemphigoid is an autoimmune skin disease that causes the skin to form bulli, or blisters. Now, the skin is divided into three layers. The epidermis forms the thin, outermost layer of the skin. Underneath is the thicker dermis layer, and finally, there's the hypodermis that anchors the skin to the underlying muscle. The epidermis itself is made of multiple layers of developing keratinocytes, which are flat, pancake-shaped cells that are named for the keratin protein that they're filled with. Keratinocytes start their life at the lowest layer of the epidermis, called the stratum basale, or basal layer, which is made of a single layer of stem cells, called basal cells, that continually divide and produce new keratinocytes. The stratum basale also contains another group of cells called melanocytes, which secrete melanin. Melanin is a pigment protein, or coloring substance. Below the epidermis is the basement membrane, which is a thin layer of delicate tissue containing collagen, laminins, and other proteins. Basal cells are attached to the basement membrane by hemidesmosomes, a protein complex that stems from the bottom of the basal cells. Just like how an anchor digs into the seafloor and holds a boat in place, hemidesmosomes dig into the basement membrane and hold basal cells in place. The exact cause of bullous pemphigoid is unclear, but it's thought that in a person with a genetic precondition, it can be triggered by medications like furosemide, captopril, penicillamine, nonsteroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, also called NSAIDs, and antibiotics. Bullous pemphigoid is a type 2 hypersensitivity reaction, which is when the immune system produces antibodies that bind to the body's own cells. Immune cells, called B cells, produce IgG antibodies, which are Y-shaped molecules with two regions. An antigen-binding fragment region, or Fab region, and a fragment crystallizable region, or FC region. The Fab region of the antibody binds to pathogens, which helps other immune cells destroy those pathogens. The antibodies can also activate a part of the immune system called the complement system, which destroys the pathogen, or induces inflammation. In bullous pemphigoid, the Fab region of IgG antibodies binds to proteins that make up the hemidesmosome. One of the proteins is called bullous pemphigoid antigen 1, or BPAG1, which is also called dystonin, and another protein is called bullous pemphigoid antigen 2, or BPAG2, which is also called BP180, or type 17 collagen. So lots of names for the same thing. The FC region activates the complement system. The process gets started when C1, the first of the complement proteins, binds to the FC region of the antibody. C1 then engages other members of the complement family, C2 through C9, some of which are activated by being cleaved or chopped by an enzyme. The cleaved fragments, C3A, C4A, and C5A, act as chemotactic factors, meaning they attract certain cells, in this case, the mast cells. The mast cells degranulate and release molecules like tumor necrosis factor alpha, leukotrienes, and cytokines. These molecules attract inflammatory cells like neutrophils, eosinophils, macrophages, and T cells. These inflammatory cells then secrete proteolytic enzymes, which destroy the proteins of hemidesmosomes, BPAG1 and BPAG2. So if an anchor breaks and can no longer hold the boat in place, the boat floats away. So, when the hemidesmosomes are destroyed, the basal cells separate from the basement membrane and a split forms between the dermis and epidermis, resulting in what's called a subepidermal bulli. These subepidermal bulli are distinct from the epidermal bulli which form in the disease pemphigus vulgaris. In fact, in pemphigus vulgaris, the bulli form as a result from breaking connections between cells within the epidermis. Now, in bullous pemphigoid, the inflammation also affects the melanocytes, which produce more melanin that gets stuck within the cells of the dermis. Bullous pemphigoid is most commonly located on the lower abdomen, flexor side of the forearms, and anterior or inner thighs, but can also involve other areas as well. Unlike pemphigus vulgaris, it doesn't typically involve the oral mucosa. Early on, there's a red and itchy rash, and over time, it develops into large bullae, or blisters. The blisters typically evolve over a few days and leave behind crusted lesions that heal without scarring. A classic way to help distinguish bullous pemphigoid from other skin diseases, like pemphigus vulgaris, is the Nikolsky sign, which is when lateral pressure is applied to the lesion and it causes a split to form between the upper and lower layers of the epidermis. In bullous pemphigoid, the skin doesn't split. Pemphigus vulgaris will have the Nikolsky sign, but bullous pemphigoid won't. In addition, a skin biopsy can be done to look for evidence of antibodies and complement infiltration into the skin. Finally, the blood can be checked for autoantibodies against BPAG1 and BPAG2. Bullous pemphigoid is most commonly treated by stopping any medications that could be triggering it, and by using corticosteroids. Alright, as a quick recap. Bullous pemphigoid is an autoimmune skin disease mediated by type 2 hypersensitivity. Autoantibodies form against BPAG1 and BPAG2, and they allow blisters to form between the dermis and epidermis layers of the skin. Large, tense blisters on the lower abdomen, arms, and legs are the most common symptom. There is no Nikolsky sign, however, but there are circulating IgG antibodies, and this condition is usually treated with corticosteroids.
Thanks for watching. If you're interested in a deeper dive on this topic, take a look at osmosis.org, where we have flashcards, questions, and other awesome tools to help you learn medicine. Otherwise, you can always support us by donating on Patreon, subscribing to our channel, or following us on social media.